Thank you. Scott's story. On March 12, 2008, my life completely changed forever. I was 12 years old and my sister was 18 years old. My sister picked me up from middle school on a Wednesday, and the sun was shining and the windows were rolled down and we were singing and laughing, something that my sister and I usually never really did. When I came into the world, my sister was 6 years old, so she was the only child pretty much up until that point. So of course, when I came into the world, I completely rocked it. And I was the annoying little sister that she absolutely hated. And so we didn't have the best relationship growing up. But, you know, we were riding in the car and we had no idea what was about to happen. And less than a mile from our house, everything stood still. All I remember is seeing red and smoke. And I look over at my sister, and a texting driver had swerved into our lane and hit his head on. And she was in a hurry, and she was going 65 miles per hour in a 45. And she was in a hurry, and she was texting her friend, telling her that she was on her way, and when she looked up, a school bus had stopped in front of her. And instead of veering over to the right in an open green pasture, she swerved into our lane and hit us. And I will never forget my sister reaching over with her broken wrist and said, "I love you, and everything's going to, you're going to be okay." She didn't say everything, she said, "You're going to be okay." And a man that was behind us called 911. And he came up and he grabbed my hand and he did not leave until I was there, or until, you know, the cops showed up. And so many things happened and I blacked out. And when I came back to, there was a lady asking my sister for my mom's number. And my sister was unconscious, so I told her my mom's number, and I just remember seeing my mom being 22 now and realizing what, you know, I put her through and having her have to watch that. But I heard the helicopter, it landed, they took my sister away, they took me away, I was put on a stretcher and I was taken to Gainesville, they flew my sister to Atlanta. And I didn't find out till later that night if my sister was even alive. And being a 12-year-old little girl, I didn't know how I was supposed to process that. I didn't understand why God decided to keep us here on this earth, because he could have taken us so quickly. And why didn't he? There were so many questions going on in my head, and I struggled with this for many years. Come to find out, my sister broke her femur, and she has a rod and two screws. She broke her wrist, and she has a plate and two screws. And I was born with scoliosis, but they told me that my they were just going to keep a watch on my curvature, and that I wouldn't have to have surgery as long as they kept it, you know. And I don't remember anything that happened in the accident, but they had told me that my sister saw me ball up, and that's what caused me to eventually have scoliosis surgery. So now I have two rods and 27 screws due to a texting driver. And the song that I sang for you was called 10,000 Reasons, and it took me a really long time to figure out God kept me on this earth for 10,000 more reasons. I wasn't finished yet. He didn't want to take my life just that quick. He gave me another chance at life. I have gotten to see my sister get married. I have gotten to see her have her three kids that I'm an aunt to. I went on to be the national spokes team for the AT&T It Can Wait campaign, which is prevention of texting and driving. I got to see my mom beat cancer. I've got to see both of my grandparents turn 80 years old. God has given me so many reasons to live and to be here. And we all have a story, and we all have 10,000 reasons to live and serve him. God for giving me one more reason to be here. And I don't tell you this to be sad, but to just share my story. Even in the worst times, we can thank God for everything because it's who I am today. And my favorite verse is John 13:7. And it's, you do not understand now what I'm doing, but someday you will. And I take that with me, and I go for that every day. So, that is my story. Thank you for listening. Texting and driving and what you can do. And now Apple has come out with a drive mode where if you are in the car, you can turn that on and your phone completely shuts down. So not completely, but just enables the texting part.